Hey, what's going on, everyone? Gareth here with FCP Euro, and today we're going to do another really quick product review. So what we have here is a rear control arm kit for the F25 X3s and F26 X4s. All of the rear suspension components are going to be the same, regardless of model or drivetrain type. But this is everything in the rear suspension in terms of the control arms, not necessarily the bushings on the physical wheel carrier itself. That's a completely different situation. With this rear suspension design, these components are relatively weak as opposed to a cast alternative like this. Unfortunately, there's no other options when it comes to these rear suspension components. This is pretty much what you get. The areas of concern on these components themselves is gonna be the bushings, which are pressed in. Most of these cannot be replaced independently. They're only available with the control arm, as well as potential damage that could occur to these control arms with a curb strike or something like that. These are relatively flimsy and they could bend. They can also easily rust over time as well. Areas like this here, where there's like a large pocket or even an area like this, these can collect a lot of moisture and a lot of dirt over time and start to rust through. So it is a good idea to keep your eye on that, especially if you live in an environment where there's a lot of salt. In addition, you have your rear sway bar links, which are actually made out of plastic. There is no metal in these at all, with the exception of your little joint here for physically bolting to the sway bar itself. These are basically nylon and they're glass fiber reinforced 30%. So they are strong, but I would expect over time these could be a weak point in the rear and these could break too. Where applicable, we also want to include the required replacement rear hardware. So self-locking nuts, eccentric bolts, any one-time use fastener. The bolts are to be most susceptible to seizing in salty environments. Inside the sleeve of the bushing are going to be these bolts that have this smooth shank on them. Even though the ZNS3 zinc coating is designed to prevent that from occurring, we all know in rust belt areas, that's not necessarily a guarantee. So if you're replacing these components, the one best thing you can do at that same time is put a little bit of anti-seize on the shank, just in case in the future, if you need to replace any of these components again, you have a much better shot of these bolts coming out easily and not fighting you the entire time. But at the time you go to replace these, it is worth replacing that hardware, just if you're dealing with any of the corrosion, plus anything that's one-time use, you're gonna wanna replace anyway. So a couple things to look out for within this rear suspension, because it is a multi-link setup. Any wear within the bushing, so tears or any kind of movement that you see within the rear suspension or free play, that's gonna cause issues with your rear alignment settings. You could get bump steer, things like that going on, or you could hear some noises coming from the rear suspension indicating that you might have a component that is really worn out and requires replacement. In addition, you know, like I said, these components being stamped steel, if you were to accidentally strike a curb or something like that, it is potential for these to bend a little bit. So it is worth checking them over and making sure that you don't have that kind of problem, because any bend with any of these links is going to cause an issue with your rear tire alignment, and you will start to wear out your rear tires, or the car may not drive straight. So this is just one of those areas that you wanna be cognizant about and check. I would say, realistically speaking, 50,000 miles is where you wanna start looking at these components in the rear suspension and making sure that you don't have any play within the wheel that would indicate that any of these bushings are worn out. Hope you learned something. If you have any questions or comments, go leave in the comment box below. Hit that like button. Also subscribe, I've got plenty more videos on the way. And as always, I'll see you for the next one. Later.